We spend a lot of time together. And to me, it comes down to that. We're on the road together, we're on buses together, we're flying, we're in, we're out, we're here, we're there. We spend more time with the players on this team than you do with your own family. And so for me, you need to create a family atmosphere. And that's about respecting people. That's about caring for people and having a genuine heart for other human beings. It's simple, but it's how I've lived my life the entire way. I don't know any different. So for me, the players on my team are family to me, and I'll respect them and care about them and make sure they're doing okay. And I'll push them when I need to push them, but that's still part of that sort of loving package. A lot of our players are professional players now. They play two or three seasons of professional basketball where there are crowds there and they're used to, or getting more used to, playing in front of people. So for most of our players, the crowd helps. It provides energy and sort of like a competitive edge that either at home you want them to cheer for you, or on the road you want to keep them quiet. So, you know, our players like playing in front of a crowd, and I think that there's a lot of eyes on them and there's a lot of people watching in any game you play, be it people on TV watching it or the fans, and to me, I want to encourage them. When they make a mistake, my first reaction wants to be to encourage them. They know they made a mistake. They're smart basketball players. They turn the ball over. They know they've turned the ball over. So one, start with encouragement, and then give them teaching. We need to give them information to improve. You can't just sort of rah-rah them to death. You need to give them the actual information they need to make the better decision the next time. And for me, that's analyzing what's happening in the game. How is the other team guarding that player, so I can give them a strategic sort of advantage in something they can do in a similar situation. And then it's about sort of, you know, keeping everyone engaged. So making sure my bench is communicating and talking and part of the game, making sure my coaches are part of it as well. For me, the more, as I say, energy we have and the more we do it together, the more successful we're gonna be. But for my team, I really preach that, listen, we create our own energy. We are an energy-driven team. We have two main tenets: bring energy and do it together. And to me, that's our little world on our side of the court and our bench. So the players that are on the court and the players that are on our bench and the coaches that are there, we create our own energy bubble. Part of my job as a coach is to figure out what are the good shots and what are the bad shots. And it's a really fine line to walk. And for us, there's a shot spectrum in which we like to shoot. Three-point shots are obviously high in that shot spectrum, corners specifically. And then obviously anything at the rim is great for us because it creates free throws, and your free throw is your best shot you can possibly get in the game. So for me, I want to encourage them to shoot three-point shots. If they get a shot open in the corner, to shoot it. And at this point, I'm encouraging all my players to shoot it. I'm trying to build a culture of comfortable shooting, where everyone feels comfortable that if the ball gets swung to them, they know they can shoot it, because often that's the right shot to shoot. And if you don't shoot that one, you're not going to get a better one any later on, and the rebounding position is in place when you shoot that one. So right now, we're encouraging everyone, and as the season progresses, guys will start to find the shots that are really theirs, and they'll start to hunt those shots, and guys will know the ones that they maybe shouldn't shoot. But to me, we want to create a culture of, and it happens in practice and it happens in games, of comfortable shooting for my entire team.